Good morning, children. Welcome to our SST class. In the last class, we were learning the two types of properties. And then tell me, which were those two types of properties that we learned? Public property and private property. And also we learned the difference between public property and the private property. And in today's class, we are going to learn another new topic, caring for school property. What is that? Caring for school property. Okay, then let me ask you, children, this school belongs to whom? It belongs to you also. It belongs to me, it belongs to you also. How come it belongs to you? Because the money what your parents pay as school fees has taken for buying the things, maintaining the things, etc. So it belongs to you also. So whose duty to them or whose responsibility to take care of it? It is each one of us responsibility to take care of our school property, especially the furnitures, books in the library, items in the sports room, okay, items in the lab, both chemistry physics labs and also in the computer labs. All these things, it is our duty to take care of. Okay, do you like anybody, breaking the leg of chair at home? Or writing on the wall, it is newly painted and left. You will immediately inform your mother, papa, your younger brother. For example, your younger brother is writing on the wall, which is newly painted, looking very beautiful. What do you do immediately? You inform immediately to your papa, saying that so and so has scribbled on the wall. Why? Because you know that it is that house belongs to. That is the reason why you immediately inform your papa or mommy, saying that, okay, my chota brother has done that work, and mommy papa comes and scold you. The same way you should have that same feeling that this school belongs to me. Okay, my parent or my papa and mommy has given some share for maintenance of it, so I should not do it, and also I should not allow any students to do it. I should tell them not to do it. Okay. Any maintenance in the school, that money is taken from the parents of the students or those who are studying in the school in the form of school fees. So it is our duty, each one of us duty to take care of our school property. Clear, children? Okay, then we will move to the next topic, that is caring for monuments. Okay, then tell me what is called a monument? Monuments are old building, which is important historically. Old building. It might have been built by our forefathers. Okay, fathers. Okay, forefathers. And in olden days, it has been built. Not with the new technology it has been built. It has been built in olden days without any technology it has been built. So it says about how India was on olden days. Okay, it shows the glory of India. And you and I, all Indian citizens, has the responsibility to take care of the monuments. Because it is our prestige. And some monuments you see, Taj Mahal, Red Fort, Qutub Minar, and so many temples, mosques, churches, all these buildings are olden buildings which even now look so beautifully remains in our country. And should not scribble on that any of the monuments. And if anybody does that work, it is your duty to inform the police regarding that. A lot of tourists comes every year to visit these monuments from different countries. And we get lot of revenue from them. It's lot of money from that. Okay, money collected entering into the monuments is used for the maintenance. So under the ancient monument and archaeological site and remains act 1958, which act it is? Under the ancient monuments and archaeological site and remains act 1958, which year is 1958? This both you have to learn. What is that act and which year? Okay, ancient monuments and archaeological site and remains act 1958. What it says, people who damage historical monuments may be prosecuted and punished. So it is against law of our country if you do any damage to these monuments. There is a section, okay, under ancient monuments and archaeological site remains act 1958. People who damage these historical monuments are supposed to put into jail and punish them with some money, etc. So important it is, children, to take care of what these monuments. As an Indian citizen, it is our responsibility to see that none of our monuments are scribbled or idols are taken it out from there. Okay. And no one destroy these monuments. I hope it is clear. So two things we have learned today. Caring for our school property. It is our responsibility to take care of the school property, because it belongs to us. At the same way, it is as an Indian citizen, it is our responsibility to take care of the all the monuments. Monuments, I told you, monuments are the old buildings which are historically important. Okay, very olden buildings, very, very olden days it has been built by our forefathers. And it says about the glory of India, and it is our duty to take care of the monuments. And 1958, what is the act? It is